What's up, my dudes? Taking a look back at the original MXGP game. So, wow, dude. This is interesting. This is cool. So, I want to start up a new series here where I go take a little old gander back at some of these older games and just kind of take a little step back in time, right? Just to give you a little bit of perspective here. That's the year this game came out, 2014, bro. That's pretty crazy, man. So this was Milestone's first, first dirt bike game that they ever made, if I'm not mistaken. So yeah, dude, just look at the graphics. That's just so cool to go back and see how all that really was back then. Definitely an interesting thing. What's all this, like, pre-made ruts and what is all this, dude? That's something you don't see on a modern-day MXGP game. What the hell is this, Milestone? You used to actually do pre-made ruts, like pre-made roughness and character on the track? That's crazy, bro. So yeah, obviously over the years, the graphics have really improved, but to be completely honest with you, the physics, I mean, this is the Milestone core physics. Like, when you go back to these games, you can just feel it. You can feel that the physics have not really changed that much over all these years. They did in Supercross 3, I will say that, but pretty much all those other Milestone games, yeah, they made the whip system where you could actually whip further over, but it was still like hitting a button and playing an animation, okay? But they just made it like you could whip further over. And yeah, they might have made it to where you could turn sharper, like in the MXGP Pro days, and which turned into quite the issue in itself. But yeah, you know, they kind of had that. It's just funny looking back because it's like this game didn't even have some of the issues that they had with games way later on down the line, you know? Like the whole popping off on every 5-foot jump that you came off of on MXGP Pro. This game does not have that issue, that little janky weird physics issue. It doesn't have that weird Supercross, when Supercross 2 first came out, that whole weird janky whip system. Yeah, the whip system is like pretty bare, pretty basic, almost like you're playing like Unleashed or something, right? You can't even hardly turn the bike over in the air. But the thing is, though, is like for Milestone's first game, this really wasn't all that bad. For Milestone's first, you know, motocross game, this really wasn't all that bad. It didn't really start getting that bad or that, like, quote-unquote unacceptable until they got deeper into the games that they were making and how frequently they were making games and all that kind of hoopla. You guys know Spencer Turley Ramp Boy, right? It wasn't even really all that bad for its time. I mean, you say for its time, this did come out, like, 6-7 years after Reflex, so you can't really say for its time, but you definitely can say it wasn't that bad for Milestone's like first game, right? And MXGP 2 and 3 were not that bad for Milestone's second and third games. You know what I mean? They weren't that bad. But it wasn't until they started getting to that, like, you know, MXGP Pro, MXGP 2019. I mean, it was just like they created more issues and newer issues that they didn't even have before. It was insane. It did not make any sense, like, at all. So yeah, this is the first track here. So let's go to another one right quick. Dude, this is crazy going back to this game. I didn't really get into the whole MXGP game series really until like MXGP 2. So I didn't really play a whole lot of this game. Let's go to a little different track ski here, my dude skis. But yeah, like this main menu screen is better than MXGP 2019's main menu screen. No joke, dog. Literally no joke. That's sad. That's pitiful. Like, what? Oh, and by the way, just another little thing here. Just another little funny thing. So, this game, the very first MXGP game, you know how you can go to the rider assist, like the rider physics options, right? All the way back in the very first MXGP game, they had a quote-unquote pro physics option in the game. So the whole MXGP Pro, yeah, they did advance the physics and all that with MXGP Pro, but it had a lot more issues in itself, though. I mean, the spinning out before you could say Bob's your uncle and the popping off on a 2.5-foot tall jump. It was insane, the problems and the janky physics, buggy physics issues that MXGP Pro had. But I just thought it was funny to kind of point out, even in the original MXGP game, they had a pro physics option, right? Whereas I felt like a lot of people got into MXGP Pro and they saw in the options of the game where you could go from like basic to pro physics, they probably thought MXGP Pro was the first milestone game that ever had that. You know what I mean? If they had never played some of these other ones, they probably thought that was the first game that had that. Like they were actually adding in a new physics option, but in reality, we've had this physics option from the very beginning. So just found that to be kind of funny, but yeah, like, for it being Milestone's first game, there's not even really anything negative I can say about the first MXGP game. I'm being serious. Like, the physics are okay. They're not, like, terrible for a first motocross game's physics. The tracks are not terrible, right? See, that's my whole entire point I've been trying to make over all these years with all these rant videos on the first Supercross game and all that kind of stuff, you know? You would, each Milestone game that came out, you were supposed to expect more and more and more and expect them to dig down in those physics more and more and more and actually change their physics and try to, you know, dig down and reinvent their physics and try to really change their games. But they just started getting in this such repetitive loop cycle of making way too many games a year to where they couldn't even spend enough time on their games to actually make proper, you know, improvements and changes to their games. Right about that, you know, after they made Super, or after they made like MXGP3, and then they got to the first Supercross game, I expected a lot more out of the physics of the first Supercross game, I'll be completely honest with you. Like, it was so overhyped for it being the, you know, the first official Supercross game that we had had in so long. It had so much hype, and the graphics and the hype around that game just sold the game. It really did. It didn't even matter what the physics were like in that first Supercross game. They were going to sell crazy amounts of copies. That game didn't even have a free ride track on it. And then they charged you as paid DLC for their one and only free ride compound in the game later on. And they still got away with that. Because of the hype train and it being the first official Supercross game in all those years, you didn't even pop off of the bike. No matter how much you overjumped or underjumped something, you never popped off the bike in the first Supercross game. The physics were just so basic and so undeveloped and so no inertia. It was insane. But the graphics and everything was tricked everybody, dog. It really did. It was a facade. And they got away with it. And they made a lot of money off of that game. But when you go back to like MXGP, the original one, you know, this was to be expected with Milestone's first game and back in these days. This was just kind of to be expected. But they've made so many games since then that just have been so unacceptable for how many games Milestone has made, you know. And like all of the not really making pre-made ruts on some of their newer MXGP games and no outside berms on some of their newer MXGP games, terrible, non-existent, really terrain deformation system in some of their newer MXGP games. I mean, there was a lot of different aspects that just were totally unacceptable. So it's just funny how you can go back to these days and it's like, wow, I literally can't even say anything negative about the first MXGP game. I just can't. It's just fine. It is just fine for a, you know, first motocross game company's game. It's just fine. There's nothing wrong with it. yeah, it's lacking probably some content and some little things like that, but I mean, dog. So you see why, you see how the sort of, you see where all those rant videos were actually developed from. You see how all that happened over time. It wasn't just 0 to 100 real quick, whole squad on that real shit, let me start ranting on Milestone real quick. Oh my God, what are you doing, Milestone? This all developed over time, right? You didn't see me making a bunch of rant videos on MXGP2. You didn't see me making a bunch of rant videos on MXGP3. It wasn't until they had continued with those same basic no inertia and not really changing their physics and not really making, you know, actual skill gap to their game and proper, you know, fun factor skill gap to their game. It was after all those years. That's what created all those rant videos. And then they went to MXGP Pro and went backwards in a lot of ways. And then MXGP 2019, the most basic main menu screen you've ever seen in your life. And just like, it was just so many the super unacceptable whip system that Supercross 2 had whenever it first came out. I know they fixed it in an update later on, but oh my God, that was atrocious. Oh my God. Like, so I'm just saying, it is, all of those rant videos happened over time, man. They happened over Milestone having a chance to prove themselves. Right? Like, let's just say the first Supercross game came out and it had the physics of what Supercross 3 has in it right now and the track content and all that kind of stuff. You wouldn't have seen me complain about that first Supercross game nowhere near as much as you did in those first Supercross game rant videos that I made. But it wasn't like that. They were trying to rush the game out the door. Quick cash grab. Let's make really amazing graphics and official riders, but not really put our time into the physics and the actual gameplay side of the game. What really matters. And they tricked everybody. I mean, straight up, that's what they did. And I don't know how much more I can explain that other than them coming out with a game like Supercross 3 that has so much more advanced of a physics system, so much more advanced skill gap and replayability and fun factor and jump rhythm skill gap and whipping system to the game, being able to turn both your thumbsticks the same direction to whip like in Supercross 3, you know. Supercross 3 is what Supercross 1 should have been. Through and through, dog. No other way to say it. Like, straight up, broski. And that's really all there is to it. But, yep. This is the OG. This is the OG, dog. This is the original MXGP game. Just wanted to come back and take a look at it. Pretty cool, dude. I want to start this series and really try to continue it and go back and look at a lot of other games as well, a lot of other old school games. I really want to make this into a whole thing, so I appreciate all the support. Don't forget, if you guys want to get in my Discord, all you got to do is DM me on Instagram at Spencer Turley, no spaces and no capital letters, and I'll get you in my Discord. And don't forget to hit that notification bell for my channel if you haven't already, because sometimes YouTube does not send out all the notifications for my videos. So yeah, I appreciate the you know, the hitting the actual notification bell. But yeah, man, appreciate all the support. Look at that, man. That's cool though. When you go back to these, some of the corners actually had burnt, like bigger berms around the outside. They tried to kind of create some pre-made ruts. Yeah, you're not really digging down in any of them, but like for Milestone's first game, this was great. There was no problem at all with this. I can't even think of anything negative to say about this at all. I'm sure some of the multiplayer servers probably had some issues and some other little things like that, obviously, right? But when it comes to just the straight up gameplay of it, this is what you expect with a motocross company's, you know, a motocross game company's first game. This is just what you expect, you know. It's just fine, man. This was just fine for some game company's first motocross game. I'm serious. Like, I know some of you Spencer Turley haters thinking all I can do is hate on Milestone, just can't accept that, but I'm being straight up, being honest with you. there wasn't nothing wrong with this game, dude. Like, for what it was and when it came out and all that kind of stuff, there wasn't nothing really wrong with it. I just think there was so much more expected out of Milestone, especially by the time we started getting to that MXGP3 and first Supercross game era. It's just so much more that was expected than what we actually got at that point. But I think they've learned their lesson, so we'll see where it goes from here. But appreciate you guys watching all the videos. Later, dudes.